I'm Chris Edwards with Tennis Warehouse, and I'm here with Grand Slam champion Murphy Jensen. Murphy, how are you doing?
I'm doing great, never better. Here with Tennis Warehouse, making some magic.
Now, what would you attribute your success to in doubles? I mean, obviously you had a great doubles career. What do you think the key was for you?
I think what Luke and I will be most known for is having fun on the court and working as a team. Constantly we battled hard in practice. So when we got to play in the big show and the big houses and the great stadiums around the world, that was time to have fun. I think a lot of people forget that, you know, the game is supposed to be fun. I think the hard work happens on the practice courts, and the fun happens in the tournaments.
Now, so you played with your brother all those years. Was it tough carrying him through all those draws?
Well, yeah, you know, it wasn't so tough then, but now, you know, after 7 back surgeries and a few epidural shots and all kinds of medical attention from then to now, you know, it's post-tennis where you have the biggest problems. And it's great because today people say, you know, do you still play a lot together? Actually, we've got a 4,500-mile buffer. He's in Syracuse, New York. I'm in Los Angeles, California. I'm a big celebrity movie star out in Hollywood. He's, you know, Mr. Syracuse Tennis.
And you guys, obviously, you know, very successful at the French. Was clay, you know, good surface for you guys? How did that work out for your game? Is it a good fit?
Well, growing up in northern Michigan, you know, with a lot of snow, we had to shovel the snow off the court to hit a few balls. I think that really prepared us for the red clay of Roland Garros. The French never played on snow before, anyone in Europe. And if you can play on snow, if you can play in Alaska, if you can play in North Dakota, those are the great tennis, clay court tennis players. I mean, that's where you're going to find them. It's not going to be down in Florida. It's not going to be here in Palm Springs. It's going to be in the snow belt country.
Now, obviously, you had a great partner in your brother. You know, you didn't carry him all those years. And what should a player look for in selecting a doubles partner? If they've, you know, if they're a power player, should they look for someone who hits with a bit more control or touch? Or, you know, is it 2 power players the best way to go? What do you think's the best combination?
I think it's someone that you get along with not only on the court but off the court, and then you'd look at the styles of play that you've got. Luke was, you know, probably the steadier of the two, and I was the guy that could win a match all by myself or lose a match all by myself. But realistically, you might want a guy, you look at great teams, usually it's a big server and a big return guy, and then a guy who's really steady, or a great volleyer and a great baseliner. I don't think you need to have 2 guys that serve and volley real well. I think one player needs to be steady from the ground strokes, and another player needs to be really strong at the net.
And then when you switch surfaces, do you change your strategy? Do you look to play back more and stay on the clay? Or, you know, you just pretty much play your game plan, whatever the surface?
I think the better you're playing, the less you're thinking. I think the better you're playing, the less strategy you have. You know, it's like you're playing with confidence. And a lot of people say, how do you get this confidence, this elusive confidence? And you get it from playing a lot of matches. I think drills are great to get you to the match play. But the place you get that confidence, that elusive word everyone says, you know, Nadal's playing with confidence. Roger Federer is playing with confidence. No kidding. He's using a Wilson racket, and he hasn't lost in 10 years. And the truth is, you got to play a lot of matches, and the best place to do that in practice is play sets after sets after sets. I'd play best of 5 sets against Malavia Washington growing up in juniors every day. And sometimes we just play 5 sets, even though I was, you know, beating Malavia all 5 sets. I don't think Malavia ever won a set off me in high school. Isn't that true, Malavia? Nah, Wimbledon finalist. What a joke. Sorry, Mal.
And, you know, after, you know, post-career, now you're doing a lot of work with Wilson and a lot of work with the Tennis Channel. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Well, with Wilson, I get to help out with the grassroots programs. I'm involved with a lot of different clinics and exhibitions and charity events from the college level, the junior level, to the senior tennis level, because Wilson's got a line of rackets that will make any senior player play as good as Pete Sampras or Federer, I guarantee. And if you're a woman, there's Justine Henin, and she can play with that stuff. And, you know, it's unbelievable the line of products that Wilson has. And for every age group I'm now stepping into, I look at the Gullickson brothers and Stan Smith and Laver and all those guys and what they did, their rackets got bigger. And I'm like, why would Rod Laver need a racket that gives him more control, more power, easier to get through the air? And everyone talks about racket head speed. And then away from the racket stuff, I work with the Tennis Channel. I hang out with the stars of the game. I only like to work with the stars, and that's why I'm working with Tennis Warehouse. And I have a ball. Last week I was in Dubai camel riding with Elena Dementieva right before she won her final. Dune bashing with the Bondarenko sisters who just won the Australian Open. And I do a lot of fun stuff. Tonight I get to crash an exclusive player party where Nadal will be hanging out, and Raj and Djokovic and Sharapova. I'm kind of like the social chairman of the tour these days through the Tennis Channel.
And you're still finding a little bit of time to play. What Wilson racket are you swinging these days?
Well, I like to use Roger's racket. You know, I mean, the K factor, it doesn't get any better than that. And if there's any ever a question whether there's something wrong with the racket, that's impossible. It's absolutely impossible to be wrong with Roger's racket, because he's able to do things with the ball and with the racket. And realistically, what's great about his stick is I can go to a racket that's a little bit more forgiving, and still, it just depends on how I am conditioning-wise. If I'm out of shape and I need something to give me a little bit more boost on the volleys, because I've been out partying with Sharapova for 2 straight weeks, you know, they've got a stick for me.
Great. Well, we're going to catch you in action right now with a little encore demo.
Action Jensen.
Murphy, thanks a lot.
And thank you, Chris. You need to shave that head.
And I need to take it down a notch or two right now.
10 notches.
Enjoy these tips from Murphy Jensen to take your game to the next level. Work hard in practice and have fun in matches. When picking a doubles partner, find someone whose game complements your own. Play lots of sets in practice to increase confidence in match play.